When you are designing a website, out of 100, almost 90 of them are likely to use card component. Therefore, in this video, we'll build CSS card with beautiful animation. As you can see, when you hover your card, you will be able to see this animation with beautiful transition. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. As you can see, I have already created HTML as well as CSS file. Nothing much more is going on. I have just written some basic code, and also in our standard CSS file, for our inversion selector, I have just given some margin padding as well as box sizing, and for our body type, I have given the minimum height of 100 vh. And now let's change the title. For the title, I'm giving CSS card animation. And just below that, let's give the link for our standard CSS file. And within the same folder, I do have another folder named images. And within that, we have transparent image named reindeer. Now within the body tag, let's create div with class name card. And within the div, I'm creating image tag with class name card image. For the source, within our images folder, we do have image named reindeer. Let's give the same image. And just below that, let's create h1 heading with class name card title. Within that, I'm giving the same channel name, Coding Design. And next to that, let's create another div with class name card body. Within that, again, I'm creating another div. Inside that, let's create a strong tag, and I'm giving some random numbers. And just next to that, let's create paragraph tag, and I'm writing likes. You can just select this code and duplicate it. Now let's change some numbers as well as that text. Now with the help of live server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. As you can see, we do have this huge image as well as some text. Now within our standard CSS file, let's create CSS variable name dark blue, and I'm giving this dark blue color. Now let's change this font family. So for the font family, I'm giving sans serif. And also I want to give some background color. Let's give this light blue color. Now let's give some CSS code for our class card. So for the div with class name card, let's give the width of 24 rem. For the height, I'm giving 28 rem. And also let's give the background color of white. Before giving some extra CSS code for this class card, first of all, let's give some proper height and width for our image. For that, for the class card image, I'm giving width and height of 100%. And now if I give object fit to cover, now you can see proper size of image. And also along with that image, let's give the background color. I'm giving the same CSS variable named dark blue. I think now we need to bring this content exactly at the center of our browser. For that, for our body tag, let's give display to grid. And if I give place items to center, then now you can see everything is brought exactly at the center of your browser. I want to give some rounded corners around our card. So for that, if I give border radius of 1 rem, but as you can see, you won't be able to get that rounded corners. It's because each and everything width and height, everything that is occupied by our image. So what if I give overflow to hidden? Now you can see you are able to get the rounded corners around our card. For now, you can comment out this overflow. Now let's style these two elements, class card body and card title. For the div with class name card body, let's give the display to flex. Justify content to space between. And also, I want to give some padding of 1 rem. And let's bring this text exactly at the center. For that, let's give text align to center. And also, let's give a bit bigger font size for our numbers. For that, for our strong tag that is within our div with class name card body, let's give font size of 1.8 rem. I want to bring this card title just above our image. So for that, for the class card title, let's give position of absolute. And for the parent class card, let's give position of relative. Now for that card title, let's give proper position. For that, I'm giving left of 50%. For the translate x-axis, I'm giving minus 50%. and for the y-axis 500%. For the text color, I'm giving white. Now you can see that text is brought to the bottom. So for the class car, let's give display to flex. And if I give flex direction to column, now you can see everything is coming to the proper positions. And I think instead of that space between, I need to give space around. Okay, that's better. And as you can see, our car title that is still at the bottom. Now you can uncomment that overflow code. And for our class car image, you can give their flex grow to 1, flex shrink to 0, and for our flex basis, let's give auto. Okay, initially this is exactly what I want, but still our car title, it is not exactly at the position that I want. So for our car title, if I give white space to no wrap, did you see that? This is exactly what I want. As you can see, our text color and our background image color, they are blending with each other. So our text is not that visible. For that, let's give text shadow. For the X offset, I'm giving 0. For the Y offset and blur value, I'm giving 0.1 rem. And for our color, let's give this black color with transparent value. Okay, now it's looking better. When you take your mouse near to that image, at the time, I'm gonna change our cursor to pointing hand icon. So for that, for our class card image, let's give cursor to pointer. Now you can see you'll be able to get that pointing hand icon. And also for our image, initially let's give opacity to 0.94, and now when you hover our class card, at the time for our class card image, let's change its height to 75%. And also you can duplicate that opacity code and bring it down there, and let's change it to 1. Now in your browser, you can see when you take your mouse near to that image, you'll be able to see this animation, but you won't be able to get that smooth transition. So for that, for our class card image, let's give transition duration of 0.3 second. Now in your browser, you can see this beautiful transition with animation. And also when you hover that card, at that time, I want to use some different animation for our card title. For that, you can take the same code and just paste it down there. Now when you hover card, at that time, for the class card title, before that, let's give some initial value. For the scale, I'm giving 2.5. For the opacity to 0. And now you can duplicate the same code and bring it down there. And let's change both value to 1. As you can see, we are changing these two properties, so we need the transition. Therefore, for the transition duration, I'm giving 0.5 second. Now in our browser, did you see that? You'll be able to get this beautiful CSS card animation along with that beautiful text transition. You can give your own animation for your card title. Instead of that scale, you can play with translate property. So I'm just going to change Y coordinates. So I'm playing with different numbers. And in your browser, as you can see, it seems pretty good. You can play with different value and you'll be able to get different amazing animations. And let me know in the comment box how many of you have tried new different animation. But I love that zoom in and zoom out effect. So let's bring it to the previous state. If you have enjoyed this video, then definitely you're gonna love other video as well, where I have took different approaches to provide variation in animation. So if you haven't watched it, then you can check out. Links will be even in the description below. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.